Schools going through your child's things without permission. And now parents are letting everyone know exactly how they feel about that. Thanks for sticking with us. I'm Russ McCaskey.
I'm Amanda Hall. Today was the first time we heard public comments on a new draft of the Student Code of Conduct in Lee County Schools. It says in part that school personnel can search a student's possessions, locker, and cell phone without a warrant. Wink News anchor Nat Montgomery is telling us what went on inside the meeting.
If Lee County Schools decide to add this line to their Student Code of Conduct, giving school personnel the right to check your child's cell phone, would you sign it? In a Wink News poll, 82% of those who responded said no. Tuesday at this school board workshop, Superintendent Dr. Christopher Bernier said the search of students,
both for phones and for backpacks, this is not a new item.
That raises this question. Why wasn't it in this year's code of conduct? And what gives the school the right to search someone's personal cell phone?
Searching their cell phone is only done under cases of reasonable suspicion.
Dr. Bernier made it clear the search of someone's phone would not be random. But that didn't stop board members like Melissa Giovanelli and Chris Patrica from raising the same concerns as parents in our poll did. Is this kind of search legal? The school board's attorney answered that question this way.
It comes from a Supreme Court case that's pretty old, from 1985. In that case is the one that says that school districts do not have to have probable cause and do not need warrant to be able to search.
But what if a student refuses to open their phone? School board member Armor Persons told me that's when the district would get law enforcement involved. Annette Montgomery, Wink News.
While the board took no final action, we know when students and parents sign the code of conduct at the start of every school year, the district sees that as evidence everyone has read and understands what's in it.